Now in this session, we are going to connect our Arduino device with the PC. Physically we have connected the device, but now on my computer, using Device Manager, I am going to identify the device connected to my laptop. So we can use a program known as Device Manager on Windows machine. We can run or open this Device Manager program. As soon as we open this Device Manager program, we are going to get a list of devices connected to our machine, and we are going to have all these devices categorized and available. So the device which we have connected is connected as a communication port to my machine. I am going to open the ports section, and now you can see that Arduino Uno board is connected to communication port number 11 on my laptop machine. Once I have this communication port connected, now in my Arduino IDE, I am going to identify my communication port 11, and then I am going to connect to communication port 11, and I am going to transfer the program using this communication port 11 to my Arduino board. Clear? So now what will be the done? Communication port 11 is a software port which is connected to the physical hardware port, which is a USB device. This USB is connected to the USB cable. USB cable is connected to USB port on Arduino board, and on that Arduino board we are going to receive the program, and we are going to burn the program on the microcontroller, and these instructions will be handled using our EEPROM flash and static RAM which is available on our microcontroller device. Clear? So now once we are done with this, so we'll proceed to Arduino IDE. Using this Arduino IDE, first of all, within the tools section, we are going to identify the board which we want to connect to. So we are going to select that we are going to program Arduino Uno board. So I have selected this board. This will not be identified automatically. We have to identify which board we have connected, and then we have to select the specific board. So these are other boards which also can be used using this IDE. So I have connected Arduino Uno board. And now again what I'll do, I'll go to the tools section, and here this time I have to identify my communication port to which I want to connect to. So you can see that communication port 11 is the port on which my Arduino Uno device is connected to my laptop, and now I'm going to program through that communication port 11. This will be automatically selected. As a programmer, we have to use Arduino as ISP in order to program my device. Okay, so this will be the programmer who will be programming, who will take the program from the IDE and will burn it on the microcontroller. Okay, so this is the software which is going to program my written code on the microcontroller. Clear? So this is the thing. And in case if your microcontroller does not have a bootloader, then you can use this option, burn bootloader, to burn a bootloader program on your microcontroller. Clear? Once we are done, now we have to write a simple code in order to test. So in order to test, what we have is, first of all, we are going to write a basic program in order to understand how we can initialize our board and how we can view input and output from the board. So first of all, we are going to make a simple serial program in which we are going to start serial listener on our board, and we are going to display some output on from the microcontroller to my board. Okay, so now this is going to be our first basic simple program. Okay, so let's call it as first simple serial program using Arduino in C++. This is embedded C++. Okay, now so what next we are going to do, in the setup section we are going to initialize. So at the moment we want to use software serial, the serial available on my Arduino board. Using this serial, what we can do is, we can write some codes, we can burn those codes on microcontroller. Microcontroller is going to display those codes on the serial printer, on the serial interface, and using the serial interface, the value will be sent to the laptop and the value will be displayed on the laptop. So now what we'll be doing, microcontroller will be executing some instructions, microcontroller will transfer some data to the laptop, and we will be able to monitor the data from my microcontroller on the laptop using a serial monitor. Okay, clear? So microcontroller is going to write some serial data and laptop is going to receive that serial data in order to see that the microcontroller is working and he is receiving our program. So what we are going to do in this case, first of all, we are going to initialize the serial, and before writing code, I would like to take you to the references section on Arduino. And here what we can do is, let's say we are getting started with the serial first. So we are going to search for the serial APIs, and then what we can do is we can understand how these functions, classes can be used, and we are going to write the sample program. So in order to get the references here, we can simply go to serial API. You can use serial in Arduino. So now what we can do is we can go to the serial program and let's just open Arduino serial. On the reference sheet on the website arduino.cc, we have all the classes and functions available. The information is available so that we can read them and we can write the programs. Okay, so serial is one of the good class to get started with Arduino. Okay, because serial can display the output which is being executed on the board or which is being identified on the board, and you can simply display that data to the laptop and you can observe that output using serial monitor. Okay, so now, so here is a serial class. What it does, it is a serial communication class which is connected to transmission and receive pin of the board. Okay, clear? So 0 and 1 is the standard receiver and transmitter. We don't need to connect it. It is directly connected on board, which I am talking about this thing. That 0 and 1 is directly connected to the microcontroller. We don't need to connect any other thing here. This is like serial receiver and transmitter. Okay. So whatever microcontroller will be communicating, microcontroller is going to transmit that information from 1. And this one is automatically connected to the serial cable. Okay, and using that serial, we are going to receive data on communication port 11 and we are going to display it on the monitor. In order to begin, we are going to make use of this serial class, which is going to connect using standard TX and RX pins, which are also known as digital pins 0 and digital pin 1 on your Arduino board. If you are using serial, then you cannot use digital 1 and 0 to connect any other device. Okay. Now what next we can do is, once what the serial will do, serial is used for communication between Arduino board and a computer or other devices. All Arduino boards have at least one serial port and they are also known as serial. Okay. They are also known as UART or USART devices. Now what next we can do is, on the right hand side we can see that we have multiple functions available. We have a if function in order to check whether some serial data is available or not. Then you can begin communication with the serial of that Arduino board. You can end the communication. You can find data in the communication. You can flush the communication data. You can parse data which you have received in the communication in float format and integer format. You can get the peak value of the values which are coming to your serial. You can print data on a serial. You can print data with lines on serial, and these are many functions. You can read data from the serial, you can read string from the serial, you can do all these things. So now what next we are going to do, we are going to receive data and we are going to display that on the board, and we are going to make use of this serial class. So now we are on our method. So as I have already told you, within setup what we do, we begin the communication with the devices, or we begin connection with pins, whichever pin we want to connect to. All these things we do in the setup thing, okay? Because they have to be done only once. In case I want to start it again and again and again and again, then I have to go for the loop section. Let's say if I'm starting and ending after some time, and then again I want to start, then again I want to end, then again I want to start and again I want to end. If you want to do something in sequence or in loop, we will be writing those codes in the loop part. Otherwise, if you want to initialize connection with some device, it has to be done only once when you are powering on your board. So we do that part in setup. So now what we'll do, in order to do communication with the serial, we are going to make use of the serial class. So serial is the class which we have used, and within this we have static method known as begin. So using this serial class, we are going to make use of a begin method. Okay. So what this begin does, let me just show you. So here you can see that we have a method known as begin. We are going to understand the specification of the begin. What begin does, it receives an argument of integer type, and that is known as a baud rate. With this baud rate, you can define with which frequency you want to communicate to this serial. Okay, communication of baud rate of the software serial monitor and baud rate of the device which is transmitting the data has to be same. This baud rate is somewhat like synchronizing software serial monitor of the laptop with the software serial transmitter of the Arduino board. Okay, so we have to specify the baud rate, and these are some of the specific serial baud rates which are available. So you can fix something between 300 to 115200. Okay, the standard baud rate which we generally use for devices is 9600. Clear? So now what we do, now we are going to specify the baud rate. So let's say I would like to initialize that with 9600 baud rate. Okay, and now what I want to do, using this serial, I want to print something on the serial. So I will say microcontroller to print a line, and let's say welcome to first program. So this is like the loop section which is written over here. So we have initialized the serial communication on the microcontroller using 9600 bits per second baud rate. Clear? And at this baud rate, my microcontroller is going to print welcome to first program again and again on its serial monitor, and using the USB connected, we are going to read the values using the serial monitor option available here. Okay, so now at the moment, if I start reading this serial monitor, because I'm connected to communication port 11, you can see that on the top, on the bottom right section, that we are connected to UNO at communication port 11 at the moment. And if we start the serial monitor, you can see that nothing is being transmitted at the moment, because there is no program on the microcontroller. Now I'm going to burn a program on the microcontroller, and then I'm going to read data from the serial, which is coming through my microcontroller. Okay. So in order to do that, now what I will do, first of all, I can verify if my program is correct or not. So we can use this write in order to verify. So once we have verified, we are going to save that program first. I'm going to save it as sketch April 30A. So I'm going to save it. So now we are compiling the sketch. Once the codes have been verified, they will be compiled, and we are going to upload that program onto a microcontroller. And since we are connected using communication port 11, and I have specified that my board is Arduino Uno, and I'm connected through COM port 11, whenever I'm going to click on upload, my program is going to be burnt on my microcontroller. Okay, so we'll see that. So at the moment we are compiling the sketch. Once this compilation is done, we are going to upload the program on board. Once the compilation is done, you are going to receive a message that we are done compiling. Now you can upload the program. So in order to upload the program, it is going to compile the program again and is going to build the program on the microcontroller. Okay. Once the program has been built onto the microcontroller or burned on the microcontroller, then again we are going to run the serial monitor in order to see if board is transmitting some data or not. So now you can see that we are uploading the program at the moment, and here you can see that an orange light gets displayed that a program has been burned on your board. So now you can see that we are done uploading. Now once we are done uploading, now we can use serial monitor in order to see if microcontroller is burning some data on the serial port, and through that serial port we are using a serial cable, and using that serial cable we are receiving that data on the communication port 11, and using that communication port 11 we are going to display that using this software serial program. Okay, so now once we open this serial monitor, so now you can see that now within that loop he is executing some instructions, and he is giving those instructions to the USB serial, and now it is being displayed here on that machine. Clear? Okay, so since it is powered on and it is running at the moment, you can see that loop is running again and again. Loop is running again and again. Okay, clear? So it has been done. So now what we can do is, let's say if I close it and if I rewrite the program, let's say if I go to setup, and here in the setup I will specify something like this, serial.println. I am specifying that serial communication begins. at 9600 bits per second. This is a message which I am going to display while I will be setting this up, okay? And at the bottom, welcome to the first program will be running. So I am going to burn that program again. I am modifying my microcontroller memory. I am burning a new program again. So once the communication gets started between my device and the serial monitor, then we'll see what will be the output after once we do this. So we are done uploading at the moment. Now we are going to begin the serial communication between laptop and the microcontroller. So now you can see that as soon as it gets on. So actually at the moment it's running with 9600 baud per rate. So that first thing has been written and was flushed off. So what we will do, let's say carriage, no problem, don't auto scroll. We'll just begin the communication again. Okay, so what I'll do is, at the moment you can see that there is no COM port connected. I'm going to connect the COM port again. So once this COM port is connected, now I'm going to open my serial monitor. I think COM port 11 has been removed. Just hold on. We'll get it connected again. So now COM port 11 has been connected again. Once we are connected, now we'll see the auto scroll is off. So for the very first time, your serial communication begins at 9600 bits per second has been done, and it has been executed only once. But this welcome to first program, since it is in the written inside the loop function, it's executing again and again. This means your board is running. Okay? And as soon as you'll have a data, the board will respond. Somewhat like this. Okay? So you have set up your machine for a serial communication. The microcontroller is executing some data and he is giving that data to the serial monitor, and we are receiving that serial data and we are displaying that data using this. Clear? Now let's see. So now what am I going to do? I'm going to modify this program and I'm going to write something else. Now what we'll do, let's say we are going to define welcome to the first program. Okay. So let's say, so we'll do something like this. If we are going to read some data this time from the instructions, okay? If serial dot available, okay, clear? So we'll see if there is some data in the serial. If somebody has sent some data to the serial, we are going to check if serial data is available. Then what we'll do, we are going to read a string. So we are going to use the serial class, and using this we are going to use a function known as readStringUntil, until some character is found. So I'm going to read till the new line has been identified. Slash n is a new line character. Okay. So I will be reading this string and I'm going to store this inside a string, and let's call it as code. Let's say I'm going to send a code. Okay. So first of all, we'll check if serial data is available. Then we are going to read string which is coming. We are going to store that string into the code variable, and this is the data type of the variable which I have used here. Once we have done, now we'll check if, let's say we are going to say if code is equal to A. Okay. So now we are going to print something like serial.println, and we are going to specify somewhat like this: A process starts. Okay. Then what I'll do, else if, let's say we'll say if code is equal to B. Okay, we'll say, let's say the B process starts. We are just writing a simple program. In this case, we are going to give a command from a laptop to a microcontroller, and microcontroller will be responding depending on the command which has been received to it. Clear? So what we'll do, if this is available, then it's fine. Otherwise, the serial.println will be done. Okay? So let me just remove that from here. And now I'm going to specify that here. And I'm going to say something like this: serial data available. Something like this. Okay. So we are going to send some value. and whatever value is being received, we are going to display that first. Using this println, first of all, I'm going to display the code value. And we can say somewhat like this as well. Command is, we can concatenate that, okay? So this is the default string which I have used. Then I have concatenated that default string with a variable. So whatever data we are going to receive within this variable, we are going to display that first. Okay, clear? So now we are going to burn this program and we'll see if the program is compiled properly. We are going to display the value with the help of serial monitor. So in this case, what will be done? Serial monitor will be initialized. Then we will be waiting serial.read string until constant character to character. Okay, let's say if we need a character, we'll just put in somewhat like this. Now we are going to burn the program. So actually it has to be specified as a character. We have used double quotes, so it was considering as a string. So we are just compiling the sketch. So this section is known as the debugging section. If something goes wrong, you will see the errors within orange. Okay. So now the program is compiled properly and we have done uploading. So now once we are done, now once we'll open. So at the moment you can see that serial communication begins at 9600 bits per second, but it's not doing anything at the moment. So now what I'll say something like I'm sending D. So this is the input which I'm providing to the laptop. This laptop will transmit this D to my microcontroller. D will read what has been received, and if the proper value will be there, we are going to display some code. Okay, so let's say now we are going to send that. So as soon as I send, so he says serial data is available and the command is D, which you have sent, because he is continuously listening, the loop is running, and he is checking if serial data is available or not. But at the moment, no serial data is available. When I have sent D, he said that serial data is available and he has displayed that the command is D. But now, if I want to make a useful command, let's say if A is a useful command, because I have written code for A, that if A is received, do something. If B is received, do something. But if anything else is received, do not do anything. Okay. So now, once we have said, let's say we are going to receive A, as soon as we say A, so serial data is available, command which we have received is A, and A process starts. Clear? So if we have to call a specific function here, we are going to write a function and we are going to execute that. Is that clear? So this is how we write programs for serial. In this we have two functions. First is the setup function. Within setup we can start communication with a device. This is just for example, because I want to show you that setup only executes once, but the loop executes continuously. Okay? And how we will be writing codes in the loop? We are going to check a condition. If something has been received on a serial, if a command has been received on a serial, then we are going to print the command which has been received. Okay? And once we are done with this, if that command is a valid command, we are going to execute the code. So in case if we want to specify any other function here, we can specify any function here and we can write the function outside the body of this loop. Okay? Let's say if I specify a function, that I'm going to specify a void function. Void means it does not return any value. Okay? Once you execute this function, no value will be returned back. Thus, only the statements will be executed. So let's say I have said that, let's say it's a process A function which I want to execute. Okay? And within this process A function, I have simply specified, let's say serial.println. Let's say I'm going to specify somewhat like this. Process A executes here. Jo bhi lines of code, whatever the lines of code are here. So let's say I have simply specified process A executes here. And I'm going to remove that from here. Okay. If A has been identified, I'm just going to call process A. Okay. So now this process A is a function which I have defined in my code. And I'm calling this process A within my condition. Okay, so we can have as many functions. Let's say we have setup and loop should be default. By default, they should be available. Apart from these two functions, we can write any function here. So in case we want to define a custom function, we have defined process A. The statements will be defined here. And then this process A will be called if your if you will receive the command A. Okay. So now what we are going to do is we are going to build the program again on the board, and now we are going to view the data which is coming out through this microcontroller to my serial monitor on the laptop. Okay. We'll see what else we can do. Let's say. So what we'll do once the program is compiled and uploaded. Now we are going to get the display on the serial monitor. Okay. So we are going to get the display. At the moment you can see that nothing has been displayed if I have given command A and if I have sent. So he said serial data available, command is A and the process A executes here. So what we did, we have got the data available, we have printed that data is available, then we have read the string, whatever command we have specified, we have read that into code, we have displayed the information, whatever has been received in the code, we have checked the condition, then we have executed a function. Okay. In the same way, let's say, now I have a board here and I want to, let's say I want to turn on some LEDs or something I want to do. Okay. So I want to extend the connection of this board and I want to see how I can do that stuff, that I will be able to connect a device and I'm going to turn on my LED. Okay. So that we will be writing in the next session.